Welcome to a lesson on using inverse sine, cosine, and tangent to evaluate expressions and solve problems. Let's do a quick review on inverse trig functions. Y equals arcsine x or y equals inverse sine x mean the same thing, which is equivalent to x equals sine y, where y is an angle in the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Y equals arc cosine of x or y equals inverse sine of x means x equals cosine y, where y is in the closed interval from 0 to pi. And lastly, y equals arctangent x, or y equals inverse tangent x, means x equals tangent y, and y is on the open interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So the main thing we have to keep in mind here is that for inverse trig functions, the input, or these x values, are actually trig ratios or trig function values, and the output, y, is actually the angle that has the given trig function values. So for example, here on number 1, we have the sine of arccosine 1/4. Arccosine 1/4 is going to return an angle on the closed interval from 0 to pi that has a cosine function value of 1/4. Once we find that angle, or at least model it, then we'll find the sine of it. So let's go ahead and sketch a model of this angle theta. We know the angle must be in either the first or second quadrant, but since the cosine function value is positive, we're going to be in the first quadrant. So we'll sketch a reference triangle in quadrant 1. Here's our angle theta. And the ratio of the adjacent to hypotenuse is 1 to 4. So we have 1 here and 4 here. What we want to do is find the sine ratio for theta, which is the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. We can find the length of by using the Pythagorean theorem, which states that 4 squared must equal y squared plus 1 squared. Solving this for y squared, we'll have y squared equals 15, square root both sides, y is equal to the square root of 15. So the sine of angle theta will be square root 15 over 4. And that's the value we're looking for. Let's go ahead and take a look at number 2 now. Cosine of arctangent 4/3. So our angle theta has a tangent function value of 4/3. And again, it's positive, so we're going to be in the first quadrant again. Let's sketch our reference triangle. Here's our angle theta. The ratio of the opposite to adjacent side is 4 to 3. And this is actually a 3, 4, 5 right triangle, so we know the hypotenuse will equal 5 units. Now that we've modeled our angle theta, we want to find the cosine of it. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so in this case we'll have 3/5. Okay, number 3 is a little bit different. We want to find the sine of the quantity arcsine 1/2 plus arctangent negative square root 3. Arcsine of positive 1/2, what angle has a sine function value of 1/2? We can see from this 30, 60, 90 right triangle that would be 30 degrees. So we'll have the sine of 30 degrees plus, now we need to find the arctangent of negative square root 3. Looking at our reference triangle, we can see that a 60 degree angle has a tangent ratio of square root 3 over 1, or square root 3. However, since we have negative square root 3, and the inverse tangent function returns an angle between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, we're going to sketch a 60 degree reference angle in the fourth quadrant. Which means our angle theta is going to be negative 60 degrees. So going back to our problem, we have sine of 3 degrees plus negative 60 degrees, which is equal to the sine of negative 3 degrees. Let's go ahead and model this. A negative 3 degree angle would look something like this. So our reference triangle would be 1, 2, square root 3, where the y coordinate would be negative 1. So the sine of this angle is going to be opposite over hypotenuse, or negative 1/2. Let's go ahead and take a look at another problem. A 10-foot ladder is leaning up against the wall. The foot of the ladder is 3 feet from the base of the wall. How far will the ladder reach and what is the angle the ladder makes with the ground. So the ladder is leaning against the wall. This is going to be 10 feet. It's 3 feet from the base of the wall, so this will be 3 feet. So this would be actually the height the ladder will reach, and this would be the angle that it makes with the ground. We want to find h, and we also want to find theta. Well, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find h, where 10 squared must equal h squared plus 3 squared. So we'll subtract 9 on both sides, and then take the square root of both sides. Square root of 91 is approximately 9.54 feet. Now to find angle theta, I'm going to use the sides of the right triangle labeled 3 feet and 10 feet. So we could state the cosine of angle theta is 3 feet over 10 feet, or 3 tenths. Now to solve this equation for theta, we can take the inverse cosine of both sides. On the left, these two undo each other, and we're left with theta. And on the right, we can evaluate this with our calculators. Inverse cosine 3 tenths, so second cosine 3 tenths, and our angle is approximately 72.54 degrees. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more. The optimal angle of elevation a shot putter should aim for to throw the greatest distance depends on the velocity in feet per second, and the initial height, h, in feet of the shot is given by this equation. So our question is, if a shot putter can throw the shot put with height of 6.6 feet and a velocity of 42 feet per second, at what angle should the athlete throw to maximize the distance? So essentially we're going to just do some substitution here and then evaluate the arc sine. So again, our velocity is 42 feet per second. So we have 42 squared on here, and we have 2 times 42 squared plus 64 times the height, which is given as 6.6. And remember, all of this is underneath the square root. Let's see if we can do this on our calculator. Careful, we can do this all in one step. So second sine, we have the square root, we have a numerator of 42 squared divided by our denominator, another set of parentheses. We close this for our denominator, and then we close this for the inverse sine, and we have an angle that's approximately 41.93 degrees. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.